In this video, we're going to look at Design Space layers, what they are, how they work, and why they are so amazing. I'm going to go through how to use layers on both the desktop version of Design Space and the mobile app, as it's a little bit different in both. Hello and welcome to Design Space Daily, helping you learn Cricut Design Space in short and snappy video tutorials. Here is my desktop version of Design Space, and over on the right hand side is your layers panel. It's looking pretty empty at the moment because we don't have anything on the screen. If I add a shape by clicking on shapes and then choosing a heart, I now have a layer appear not only in this main bit on the left, but also in my layer panel on the right. Let's add another one. So now I have two layers. I've got the heart and the star. If I want to make changes to either of those shapes, I can either click them directly in my main canvas area, or I can click that layer to automatically select it. And once I've got that selected, I can do anything I want to it. For example, change the color or the size. If I want to do things like duplicate a layer to create a copy of it or delete a layer, I can either right-click it in the main canvas or go over to the layers panel, right-click it, and I get those exact same options in there. One of the really cool things about the layers in Design Space is when you click into it with your right mouse button, you've got this thing called Image Info, and that tells you where your image came from, which is really cool if you accidentally forget and you want to use it for a different project, or if you want to add something from the same cartridge so that it matches. You'll see you've got these other options in here to center back or move forward, so let's see how they work. I'm going to move my star over on my heart shape, but I want the heart to be in front. So I right click on my layer and click center back, and now it's appearing behind the heart. As it's now at the bottom, when I click back in, instead of center back options being available, it's going to say move forward or center front. The difference is move forward will move it one layer forward. So let's say I had three layers and my star was at the back. If I clicked move forward, it would move it into second position, but center front would push it all the way to the very front. Layers aren't just used for shapes, it's how every single thing in Design Space works. If I click the text button and add some text, that is now appearing as a new layer in my layers panel. Likewise, if I go into images and then select an image from here, let's choose this paw print heart and then click insert, that goes on to a new layer too. Layers mean that you can move each individual element of your project independently of the others. So I can move this around without it changing anything else. And if I change the color of this paw print, it's not going to change the color of any of the other layers. Sometimes an image might be made up of multiple layers. So let's have a look at that. I'm going to click into images again and scroll down until I find an image which is multicolored that I can use to show you. I know somewhere down here are some nice hearts. This is what I wanted. Let's use the paw prints. Okay, so this image is lots of different colors, and you can see in the layers panel that it's lots of layers, one for every color. Clicking on the little eyes next to each layer will hide that particular layer, which means it won't be cut when you click the Make It button. You can turn them back on at any point by clicking the eye again. Now, when I click this heart, you'll see even though it's got lots of layers, they're all moving together as one. And that's because these layers are grouped. If I click on the top, you can see it says Heart of Paw Prints, and above that it says Ungroup. If I was to click that, it separates out all the layers, so now I can't move them all together. They're all individual. So grouping is helpful for when you've got lots of different layers that make up the same thing. I have a separate video going through groups in more detail, But just to show you quickly how it works, to click one layer, press Control on your keyboard and select all the other layers you want to group and press the Group button. This has regrouped the images, so now they're all moving as one again. Getting to grips with layers and how they work will help you to understand some of the more advanced Cricut tools such as Slice, Weld, Attach, Flatten and Contour. Don't worry if you didn't understand any of those words, I have separate videos on how to use all of those tools in Cricut Design Space. But for now, just get to grips with layers, how they all work and how to group them, and that'll put you in a really good position to start designing your own projects straight in Design Space. That's it for this desktop version of how to use layers, but if you're on a mobile device, keep watching and I'll switch over to the mobile version of Design Space now. To access layers on the mobile app, look down the bottom of the screen where you've got all your options and swipe along. And then you'll see one called Layers. Click into that and you can pop up and see all your layers appearing in there. When you tap on a layer, it brings up some options. So if it's text, it gives you all your text things along the bottom. And you can also duplicate your layer, hide that layer, and delete that layer. You can click through the different types of layer to get different options and just swipe back and forth to see all of the different things that you can do with that layer. To close the Layers panel, tap the Layers button again down the bottom of the screen. So there you have it, how to use layers in Design Space on both desktop and the mobile app. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Design Space tutorials. Thank you for watching!